bananas. Frill as hell, them niggas bang on Twitter. All is well, eat a lane for dinner. Party hard so he can't remember. See, I'm the one that she called the future. Don't call me baby, just call her.
Good, good.
Joey!
I'm here with Stop Beefinradio. About to get it in. This interview out. Glad to be home, Indianapolis. What's up? I'm showing love to everybody. I'm coming out. I'm coming out September 3rd. I'm announcing it here. I'm coming from September 3rd. Location is disclosed right now, but I'm gonna let y'all know soon.
Turn the music down. Feel me? Right now in the building, man, Indianapolis, Indiana, you know what I'm saying? Our own prodigal son's in the building tonight.
Man, he's
I've been watching. This dude been working. He been working forever, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to say about 05, 06.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I was like 13, 14 back then.
But okay. I remember Mark Averis battles. I'm going to keep it 1,000.
Yeah,
so,
yeah, that's like 05.
Yeah, so about 05. And he's home, you know what I'm saying, now, fresh off of his signing,
right.
His situation,
right.
Lituation.
Come on.
Yeah, I'm doing this like Ali, you feel
yeah.
me? You feel me? All right, man, without further ado, man, my dog in the building, man, Mark Battles, man, what's up, man?
Mark Battles.
Already, man, what's up, man? Already,
man.
Bad.
It's like home's glad that you're home, boy.
Right, right.
You set the city on fire. You know what I'm saying?
Man, I wanted to come home the right way, you know?
Hey.
Like he said, I've been doing my thing for a while, but it took a while to surface at home. You know, but now it's crazy. I can't even walk around here.
Right.
It's crazy feeling. It's
cool, man. That's what it do. So we're going to get right into it with you, man. You know what I'm saying? You've been working, like you said, the music has come full circle for you. You know what I'm saying? Talk a little bit about the evolution. You know what I'm saying? Where you began from. Let's start there, man.
It's a journey. We got time, right?
Yeah, we got time, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? We good, man. We got time, man.
It's crazy because, like, a lot of people don't know. Like, I went to 8 schools from 6th grade until I graduated high school. So I seen every form of life, you know what I mean? Like every way you could live, I lived middle class and I lived at the bottom where I ain't had nothing. So that perspective is so reflective in my music.
Right.
It's like, once it was time for me to decide what kind of artist I wanted to be, and I've been in the situations where I understood the mindset of somebody that grew up in the streets, and I understood the mindset of somebody that want to go work at it, you know, behind a desk for their whole life and make 80 to 100,000. They know that's set up. Like, as soon as they graduate college, they know they got that.
Right.
So I seen those people with that type of comfort. And then I seen the people that's desperate that don't got nothing. And I've been in that situation where I feel like I ain't had no choice. So I really felt like I'd be doing myself a disservice and my people a disservice if I just go and do what everybody else is doing.
Yeah.
Because I just don't have the same outlook.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I ain't seen it just one way. So I know it's possible.
Right.
You know, and I got homies that don't know nothing else but the streets. You know what I mean?
Right.
I really ain't got no friends outside of, you know, like, the inner city. So I don't really have people that grew up privileged. But I was in that situation long enough where I seen how their mindsets was.
Right.
You know it exists and you know how they think.
Because how I grew up, it didn't make sense for me to see people like that. But I understood the mindset. And that's why I was like, my music is so much more introspective and intellectual.
Yeah. And that's the thing too, man, that I noticed, you know, as we talk, you know, Treez and I listened to the album and we started talking about you know, how much you are bringing, like, lyrics back, actually. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, and that's a perfect situation for Def Jam as well, I'm sure. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, coming from the West Side, yes?
I like to say that.
Yeah.
But honestly.
Pike High School? Just Pike High School?
But like I said, it's 8.
Okay.
8
schools. Oh, wow. Wow.
So, like, I mean, just to give a little dip on my life, like.
Yeah.
I live pretty much everywhere. You know, and I went to so many different schools, and the reason why I associate myself with the West Side. It's probably just because that's where all my friends that I still associate with, most of them are from the West Side.
Right.
So it just feels natural, you know what I mean? But I honestly, if I add up the years, I probably lived out East longer than I lived out West, honestly.
Okay.
But we just moved around so much. I went to 4 different schools in 1 year before, you know what I mean? So
wow.
I went from 108, which is a school on 38, West 38. Then I moved all the way right across the street from Tech, and I went to Harshman.
Right.
And that's, you know, Tech's middle school. Then I went to Howe, went to Manual. So it's like, I was moving, I lived out south. So it's like, I seen every walk of life, you know, everything that Indianapolis has to offer, and that's what made me so proud in my city.
Yeah.
Because I know what we can bring to the table, to the culture, if we just got a chance.
Yeah.
The key word that you said earlier that I touch on is perspective. You have a very unique perspective. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, like, this is Well Connected Wednesdays. And basically, you say you well connected to all of it. The grit, the grind. You know what I'm saying? The sparkle and the shine.
Absolutely. Already.
That's
so
real talk.
You know, moving into, you know, because I'm going to take it there. I'm going to go all the way there. So you started out, like I said, man, the Mark Avers battles. I want to know this because nobody probably remember this. But they had a contest, you know what I'm saying, for performances down at the square for Expo,
okay,
on the website,
right.
And it was like you and like Dro, man, and like a couple other people, right. And like I was watching Skip. It was Wise, okay. Skip and them. I don't know if you remember. They was like Wise Productions or something. And this guy Mark Avers battles, like, his stuff would go up like 100 people every hour, bro. I was like, how are they doing this? How are they doing this? You know what I'm saying? So, you know, talk about the evolution, man. You know, coming from them days, man, into kind of, you know, the artist that you are moving forward.
I mean, honestly, like, I always was good on the internet.
Right.
I mean, I always knew how to promote myself and market myself online. So, even in the MySpace days, like, I was one of them kids with, like, 80,000 friends on MySpace.
Right.
So, I just knew how to work that. And that kind of changed, and I wouldn't even say changed, I would say evolved into everything that I'm doing now. You know what I mean? Because a lot of my career, a lot of my success, you know, is, I got to give a big thank you to my fans online and,
yeah,
Twitter and Instagram. Like, if it wasn't for Twitter, I don't even think we'd be talking right now.
Wow.
You know what I mean? Because I didn't really have the street approach at all. Like,
uh-huh,
I ain't never passed out thousands of CDs. Well, I did back in the day, but not since I became who I am. So it was all online.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I was touring and everything just all online. It was nothing really, like, no street promotion behind that. And that came later, but we really built the base online.
Yeah. And how do you think, you know, obviously, you know,
it's digital age.
Yeah, I mean, with the digital age, how do you think that your fan base, you know, has embraced you as a different artist, you know what I'm saying, from what's normally in the club or on the radio, you know what I'm saying? Because it's almost walking a different lane, like the Wiz Khalifas, the, you know, Mac Millers of the world who got their own fan base. How has that affected that?
I mean, to be honest, like, I was never interested in being a club artist, or like, I don't like to label them because a lot of
right.
them are talented.
Right.
I mean, but I just was never interested in doing street music or like street records.
Yeah.
I heard a song you said that in it too.
Oh yeah, yeah. It never even crossed my mind. So like, even when people would try to influence me, like, you need this type of record, you need to do this, you need to do that, I just stayed the course.
Right.
You know, because I mean, for one, a lot of the biggest thing people don't know about me is how much of a businessman I am.
Absolutely.
Like, that's like swept under the rug. So
yeah.
A lot of my accomplishments came from people like putting labels on me that wasn't true. Like, oh, he got this $1 million investment and that's how he got this and got that.
Yeah.
People don't know, like, we just know how to get to that money.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's like, and that came from me growing, I mean, we all from that. So y'all know, like,
right.
When you 5, 6 years old, your uncles and everything teaching you how to hustle. You know what I mean?
Right.
Hustling don't gotta be always related to the streets. It can just be any way.
Come on,
you gotta
man.
Maneuver to go get that bag.
So yeah, like, it's a thousand and one.
Money. I was 19. I was 19, 20.
Y'all was bringing my dog out here, Joker.
See?
Come on, man. Backstory. That's why you gotta rock. The boy, you know what I mean? We know we backstory. You feel me? Yeah.
So like, I had a club at 17.
Yeah.
I mean, I had my own house. I was 17, 3-bedroom house, whatever. And And it's crazy because that honestly set me up for the biggest realization of my life. And that's, you can come up, as fast as you come up, you can go down just as quick. You
know right, what
I
mean? So right.
I was 17, I had a crib, I had a $30,000 car, 30 G's cash. I thought that was some money back then.
Right.
Man, everything slowed up. Girls kind of disappeared.
Yeah.
I'm out of high school now, looking around, and I look up, and I'm living in G-Fresh studio. You know what I mean?
Like, right. Right.
Shout out to G-Fresh. That's my big brother.
Already. Welcome home. Yeah, welcome home, G-Fresh. Welcome you already home. Know.
Yeah.
And I was living in there. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
I had nothing. And,
yeah.
And probably a year before that, I thought I was on top of the world. And wow. It really humbled me, and it got me to realize that I needed to create some residual for myself.
Uh-huh.
And I needed to create multiple residual incomes to take care of the things that I wanted to do.
Right.
You know what I mean? And
right.
That's where my mindset came from. In the street music, it's no disrespect to those artists, but
yeah,
a lot of people don't know the money ain't the same.
Nah, not at all. Not at all.
Oh,
no. It looks like it from the outside because right. The chains. But, I mean, you just do your research. People like Wiz Khalifa, they got $40-50 million.
Yeah.
Then you got talented, incredibly talented artists like a Yo Gotti.
And yeah.
He worth $2 million.
Right.
So I was looking at that like, what?
How does this make sense?
Right. So at yeah. First, it was selfish, honestly. Like, I wanted to get to that money.
Yeah.
I was starving. I ain't had nothing. And that's the only thing I could focus on was
right.
How can I feed myself? But then once we started making a little bit of money and I realized my struggles and the things I was going through related to so many people.
Right.
It was way beyond anything that money could ever, you know, ever create for me.
Yeah.
And I was like, I really mean something to these people.
Right. I saw that building, you know what I'm saying? Like, I used to, because, you know, I always catch, like, you retweet everybody that tweets you, you know what I'm saying? So one, you might look up at some point in the day and your whole timeline be Mark Battles 317, you know what I'm saying? You like, all right. So I'm reading the tweets and you see people. I remember, like, you know, when you first had separated from the Monkey Boy situation, you know what I'm saying? And you were doing your thing. And I was watching these tweets, and I'm like, yo, like, where are these people coming from? Where are these people at? You know what I'm saying? Like, where are these people at? Because, and then I saw how you reached out fan by fan, market by market. You know what I'm saying? Like, literally, person by person. Young one was over there, person by person. You know what I'm saying? Touching every person. You know what I mean? And that's how I recognized that, you know, the fan base is there. It's coming.
Truly,
you know what I'm saying?
Interactive.
Yeah.
Truly, I mean, interactive.
It really came from, like, we were just talking about Jimmy. Shout out to Jimmy, man.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know my father, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I look at him as a big brother, but he was almost like a father in my life, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So when I was, I think I was over with, at Monkey Boy, I was 18 years old.
Yeah. So it was like, wow, it's been that long.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
So me being introduced to that, you know what I mean? I
was
18, 19, and I seen the way he moved, and I seen the way he handled his team. He had 30, 40 people.
Yeah.
Around him, you know what I mean? Almost every day.
Right.
But he moved like it was just him.
Right.
The world revolved around him, but he did it in such a way that it inspired me, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it was like, but I ain't no street dude, so I took that approach and I was like, I'm gonna turn this into something that's more fitting for my life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So yeah.
Shout out to Jimmy, man.
Shout out to
Jimmy to death. He taught me so much, man.
That's what it do.
You know what I mean?
Already.
I take that away, but
yeah.
I just needed to leave that situation only because my vision was so big.
Yeah.
And I think I dream so big it scared people.
Yeah.
So sometimes I'll be in the studio saying stuff and he's looking at, I mean, excuse my
Nah, voice. You good.
They looking at me like,
right.
What?
Right.
What are you talking about that? Like, we about to hit the club. And I'm like, man, forget the club.
Right.
We do this, we do that, we do this. We'll be on tour next year.
Right.
People looking at me like, tour? Like, what? Tour?
Like, we'll really be hitting the club.
Yeah. So it was just so much more that I wanted to accomplish. And I knew that I just had to go out here and do it myself and show that it was possible. So like you said, like 2011, 2012, when I was getting those fans, it's so funny because people back home thought it was fake.
Yeah.
I remember, like, you know, B-Swift, you know, shout out to B-Swift. He was hitting me like, people don't think that you got a real fan base. And I'm like, huh?
Right.
They think you got fake people on Twitter. I'm like, what? And
right.
It made me realize that. I didn't even get mad, though. It's crazy. It made me realize that, like, being from Indianapolis, actually accomplishing something seems so far-fetched to people that they attach on to something that's way more ridiculous than actually
believing. What's reality?
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that was that made me realize, like, it's so much more that I can accomplish and I can show people So they can't believe that you can really go out here and do it.
Yeah.
Because I was hearing stuff about me that was just so ridiculous.
Like, yes.
I got all these millionaires behind me and all this. And we sitting there eating noodles. You
know yeah.
Where they at?
Yeah, like you're talking about DJ Young One. He didn't have a bed for 4 years.
Yeah.
Air mattress, 4 years straight.
Going on the grind.
Tripping, never complaining.
On the grind.
And I'm online reading comments about myself, and I'm getting on Facebook checking the people back home, and they like, oh, he got millionaires behind him, and that's the only reason why he getting fans. And I'm like, well, tell the millionaires to bring me some cereal in here or something, because we starving. You know what I mean?
Right, right.
Starving. And people just didn't know we was really hustling, man.
Yeah.
Me, him, Brittany, you know what I mean? Like, my team, I still got the core people that helped me start everything, and that's why I think I can stay so humble and stay so connected.
Yeah. So let's talk about the situation. You know what I'm saying? The lituation. You know what I mean? Fast forward now, you know, you've met up with one of the Midwest, you know, best producers. Right. Right. He taught the dude who is the dude.
Come on.
No
man.
ID taught Kanye West everything he knows. You know what I'm saying? I happen to know No ID through a fam of mine, right. Antone. Right. You know, when we used to rap back in the days.
Right.
But they was they that, yeah, oh no. No. We don't want to hear nothing about it. No. But you know, talk about that situation and how you and No ID got together. How, you know what I'm saying? He decided, hey man, it's time for the Midwest to turn up and put battles on Def Jam. Let's go.
Right. Well, it's crazy, man. I actually went and met with No ID back in 2014.
Mm-hmm.
So I went up to the Def Jam building. And I'm like, oh man, like. This is No ID. This is Def Jam. I was so caught in the moment because I hadn't accomplished the things that I've accomplished now, and I hadn't back then.
Right.
Everything that I'm doing now at that time was just more ideas. Like, I could do this if I had this opportunity.
Right.
So I went in there just like anybody else. You know what I mean? I really didn't have too many other offers. And honestly, I think he kind of sensed that, you know, and he just felt like it was just premature for us to finish something.
Right.
So I was about to do the deal with Def Jam 2014, man, and it fell through. And I told myself, I was like, I'm about to go have a crazy, crazy, crazy 2015. I'm going to go on like 3 tours. I'm going to drop like 3 mixtapes. Then top of the year, 2016, I'm going to go get a label deal. I told myself that in 2014.
Right.
Dream big.
Right.
And when I tell you it worked exact, you would
just like that.
You think I went in the future. You know what I mean?
Right.
And that's just... Thanks to God, you know what I mean? I think it was just in the plans, but it's crazy. Everything we said we was going to do, we did it, and it worked out exactly how we wanted it to work out.
Right.
Mm-hmm. With this situation.
Right.
I wanted to sign directly to a label. I wanted the label deal. I wanted the partnership. And I felt like I deserved that from all the work I put in and, you know, all the money we made, to be quite frank. Like,
right.
We made a ton of money, too. So it's like, that's what they care about. So I'm right. Slapping it on the table like, look. I got you.
What's happening?
You know what I mean?
Right.
You can't try to give me something I already got. So we can't talk nothing in the hundreds. We got to really talk business.
All right.
Make this work. And let's talk longevity. Not no 2-3 years. I'm not going to give you a single that's going to be hot in the club for 6 months and disappear. I'm dropping albums. I'm bringing new artists through that's going to have 5-10 year careers.
Right.
So it just made sense for us to build a partnership together.
That's what it do, man. And he's all
smart
about his business.
Right,
you know what
here,
I'm saying?
Man.
Yeah, he's
first
all about his business.
Said, people don't know how much of a businessman I am.
Absolutely.
You know, so that's very important, man. I'm just sitting up here, man. I'm like, man, I'm so proud of the cat, man. You know, that one, your first thing you said is that you said you wasn't going to, you know, take the negativity and allow it to, you know, control you or put you, you know, in no frame of mind.
Right.
You know, you stayed humble with it. You know,
right.
You look past all of that because... It's real easy when people ain't checking for you or they hating on you back at the cut to be like, well, bump y'all. I know what I'm doing. You know
right.
What I'm saying? But you didn't. And I seen when you came to the crib, you know, everybody and their mama was sharing. You
right.
Know, got to deal with No ID, Def Jam. You know what I'm saying? You know, so it was heavy action. And then, look, you here with us.
Absolutely.
You know,
so,
hey.
Showing
you know,
love.
Yeah.
When I tweeted, like, I'm about to do an interview with Stop Beef, and everybody was hitting me up like, oh, man, like, we want to do the first interview, and we'll pay you. I'm like, nah.
Yeah.
I remember him posting stuff about me in 2012, talking about Next to Blow and all of this when nobody else was saying nothing. And that's how you keep it real, you know what I mean? And
absolutely.
The only thing come on, man. Like, I got some plans for y'all. I got some opportunities. And network together. And
absolutely.
Something that's consistent.
Yeah, real that's time, what's real. Up, man.
And, shouts out to the homie Jelly.
Yeah, shout out to the homie OG Jelly, man. Yeah, you already know. Making sure the hood get it first. Come on now. Jelly said the hood got to get it first, baby.
Jelly.
Come on now. That's what it do. So
I
like,
just go back to the example of what you say. You know, you got that team. You know the importance of that. You know, that's it right there in the making right there. You gotta have that team.
Yeah, the home team is important, man.
Yeah,
like we wouldn't even be having this conversation if it wasn't for people like Jelly.
Yeah,
DJ Young One and yeah, and, you know, Brittany, all my team, man. But like, to be honest, like, it's really important for me to create more opportunities for our city, man. And that's why I'm here right now.
So right.
I'm taking the opportunity. This is exciting. It's a moment.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, I'm home. Okay, that's cool. But if I don't turn this into something positive,
right,
and we keep losing these 12 and 13-year-old kids, you know what I mean?
Like, right. Oh, man.
What does it matter what I go out here and do?
Right.
And that's why I wanted to make it a big deal when I came home, because I'm tired of losing my family members and my friends and, you know what I mean, going to having to fly from L.A. and coming to funerals every 2 weeks. Like, it's really getting crazy to the point where it ain't even fun to just sit and converse about the city because you're going to bring up something negative.
Right.
So how do we change that, though? You got to put positive people in the light, but they got to be successful, too.
Yeah.
Because it's like, how you going to tell me something if you ain't doing nothing? That's how these kids is looking at it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Come on, boy.
That's why I was like, okay, I come back, and then everybody, like, every time I go somewhere, like, where you from? I'm like, Indianapolis. They don't say nothing about the Colts. They don't say nothing about the Pacers. They be like, how'd you make it out of there?
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Man, you feel me? I'm like, man, I'm talking every time.
Already.
I'm sending these memes with these labels, and all they want to talk to me about is how dangerous my city is and what was it like growing up in this environment. And I feel like we got so much more to offer than that.
We do.
Yeah. Oh, way much more, man.
That's what my mission is, man. I want to put people in position to go out here and win. I don't care what nobody say. It's not cool for us to keep killing each other.
Not at all.
I'm tired of it. You
yeah.
know what I mean? Like, yeah. straight up. So we need to do something else. What's wrong with getting some money?
You know right. what I mean? Like, right.
Nothing who wrong with that.
Who don't want to do that?
Hey, and then hold on. You talking about getting some money. Right about now, like Jay-Z say, only dudes moving units, M, Pimp, Juice, and us. Truth be told, the cast is like R&B, you know, on you know with the urban appeal, with the hood appeal, and yourself is only ones that's getting the real looks right now. Nobody wants to put you on tour if the insurance is gonna be, you know,
$1 million.
Yeah, come on, man. You know what I'm saying? Because you know it's gonna bring drama with you. I seen your shows. The people out having a good time. Right. A very eclectic mix of people. You know, they jump.
Yeah, man, where did that come from, man? Who y'all start shooting streamers in the air? Y'all got bubbles.
Party.
God, I saw a giraffe. I said, damn.
Like I said, it just all stemmed from, really stemmed from me trying to find every way I can to create an atmosphere around myself, an energy around myself that was going to be unmatched.
Yeah.
So, like, at the time, you know, I'm young. I'm still working on my craft. So, like, 2-3 years ago, a lot of artists always feel like they the dopest.
Right.
I'm telling y'all straight up, craft and polishing it, I'm going to put on the best concerts in the world.
Yeah.
And that's how I felt. So, it's like, okay, my music a 7, but my show's a 10.
Right.
So either way, you're going to spend that money with me.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And then once I got consistent on the road, I really just got in that studio and I really sat down and I focused on that music, man.
Right.
And without the music, that's the centerpiece. Like I wouldn't be here. You know what I mean?
Right.
These people don't care about nothing else but the music.
Right.
You know what I mean? So.
And speaking of that, you know what I'm saying? I want to take this time out because the joint before the deal. Before the deal,
right?
We got you. You know, somebody got a little something for us to pass along and get over to you. It ain't nothing big, you know what I'm saying? But we wanted to show our appreciation, you know what I'm saying, before the deal, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? We put you together a little something, you know what I'm saying? You know, Sheep Life. Shout out to Sheep Life and Stop Beefing Radio. That's what, you know, it says, you know, and it got some hooks, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, hey, hopefully that come in platinum next time, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? There's some gold with it, you know what I'm saying? But we want to make sure, man, that, you know, we got you something, man. We appreciate what you're doing for the city and what you're doing, you know what I'm saying, for the brothers around you that's doing their thing, you know what I'm saying? So that's our token, man, you know what I'm saying? You know, already, man. Already, man. That's, you know, I want to make sure we got that.
You earned
it. Yeah.
Thank you. You earned it. You know what I'm saying? And you got, look, you just said, man, I got all these opportunities, you know, to do some different things. Why not do it for my people? Right. You know what I'm saying? Now, that God don't make no mistakes or whatever. You know, like, it might have been a cat that maybe on a little rougher edge or whatever. He wouldn't end up in the same situations you in because, you know, humility not necessarily there.
Here, hold on. We're gonna switch mics, man, because they all want to hear you.
Okay.
The people keep saying, turn you up. Turn him up. So we just going to switch mics, man. We're going to do it right in the middle of the show. You feel me?
Yeah. But, bro.
We want to make sure that we hear him. They don't care. They don't want to see
yo, yo.
They didn't want to see me.
Man, I hope y'all heard everything
all
I said.
Man, they heard you, man.
The humility,
but
though, bro.
They wanted to turn you up. So go back. Go ahead.
Yeah, the humility, bro. You know what I'm saying? The fact that, you know, your desire ain't just to have yourself be put on, but to put on for your city and to put your city on. Right. You know, like, everybody don't think like that.
Nah, man.
You know what I'm saying? God don't make no mistakes. That's why he put you in that position.
And I totally believe that. And it's crazy because, like, I ain't going to lie. Like, I used to read the stuff people were saying. You know what I mean? Because it wasn't really too much information out there about me as far as, like, if you was from Indianapolis. Because my whole movement was winning outside of the city. So it was hard to really understand it because nobody around you, if you was from here, was feeling that energy. You know what I mean? Right. So until now where you can see my fans is walking around in this area now too, and my fans and gravitated over into the inner city. So now people like, oh, I get it. But like, people don't understand. They be like, oh, he laughing, he don't put on for the city. I got 11 people that work for me, and 8 of them is from Indianapolis.
Wow.
Don't nobody talk about that. You know what I mean? They don't got no other jobs. This is what they do, is fly America. Right. So it used to hurt me. I ain't gonna lie. I've seen people, he forgot about the city, ain't put nobody on. I'm like, man, I put 8 niggas on. What you mean? They feeding their families. They taking care of their people off of what we building.
That's real.
And I realized, like, I can't come out here trying to get approval. All I can do is just do what I feel like is right. And if people with it, they with it. If not, they not. You know what I mean? And even when I was coming home and everybody from the label like, oh, don't ship the Maserati home. You know, those Indianapolis guys, they might get you. They might get you. I'm like, if I live my life like that, worried about my own people in my own city coming to do something negative to me, then I ain't going to be able to do none of the stuff I wanted to do anyway. Right. You know what I mean? So I'm pushing down 38th Street in it. Like, you know what I mean?
And hold on. Now, you know that there. When you talk about NapTown, you know what I'm saying?
38.
Was it Trey?
Straight up.
Come on, man.
I went straight to.
Man, when you was dreaming on the rap stuff, man. Right. Was it? You said
I always wanted to do
Maserati
it.
Going down 38th Street.
I always wanted to, man. Come on. I don't know if y'all know DJ Danny. Shout out to DJ Danny, man.
Free. But he's home.
Absolutely, absolutely. And when I was young, man, like, Danny was the first person I ever seen with some money. So it was like, we was kids, we starving, we broke, you know what I mean? He used to come around, give us $200-$300, me and young one, I'm 15, 16. Right. He pulling up in the Chargers and all of that. And I was just attracted to that. And you know what I mean? Whatever he was doing to get it, I wasn't even interested in. Yeah. I just was like, I want to be like that. Yeah. You know what I mean? And it was such a shallow way of thinking once I grew up, because I didn't know the sacrifices he had to make to get whatever he had.
Right.
And then as you get older, you realize it takes so much work to get in whatever position you getting in. You don't just look at somebody and say, I want what he got. You look at somebody and be like, I'm going to work as hard as he worked. And that's how I see it.
Repeat that one more time, man. Repeat that one.
I don't know if it's gonna hit.
We might make that into a meme right there, man. You know what I'm saying? We might have to make that into a meme right there, man.
Hey, I don't know if it's going to hit the same way if I say it twice.
I know, man. All right, we'll let it lay. My man said, man, when you look at somebody with something, man, you don't right. say, I want what he got, man.
Right.
I want to work as hard as he did to get it.
Absolutely.
Come on, man. You got to want to work hard.
I'm going to put that one on for you right there, man.
Straight up. If you listening, shout out DJ Danny, man. I was a kid, and I didn't even know it was possible to have anything. You know what I mean? When you so confined and constricted to whatever is around you, and I even realized, like, Indianapolis middle class ain't even real middle class. Like, right. our middle class is just black people who making $2-3 more dollars than the person 10 minutes down the street in the ghetto.
Right.
It ain't no real middle class. They struggling, they living paycheck to pay. Exactly. So it's like, don't nobody got nothing. You know what I mean? And right. the people that do got something, they only got something compared to everybody who don't. They right. really ain't living the way they want to live.
Right.
And he was just the first example of me seeing somebody with an abundance of something and the happiness that brought to his family and his friends, and that inspired me to want to go out here and be something big. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's so, I mean, and it's so crazy, man. Like I said, man, you know, before the deal came now, you know, mm-hmm. behind all of this, you know what
absolutely.
I'm saying, culminates to before the deal.
Right.
Just dropped May 31st.
Absolutely.
So if you don't got it, get on Come iTunes. On, man.
And we tearing them charts up.
Get that get album. That.
Go get it right now,
so
please.
The title, man, before the deal, man.
Right.
Talk about that, man.
Man, honestly, I want to say No ID came up with that name.
Yeah.
And we was just looking for something to just, you know, to spark the year off, and right. everything with the deal was supposed to happen earlier this year.
Okay.
So we had a lot of the music done, and nice. You know, things change, and he was working on a few things, I was working on a few things, so we announced everything kind of late, and honestly, we ain't even announced everything, you know what I mean? Like, people can't dig into the deal yet, so like,
right.
we're going to do a whole nother announcement, and it's going to give all the details, right?
Official.
Yeah, but
they don't know what the check was.
Right, we...
They don't know what the check... They going to... Hold on, they going to say, man, hold on, man.
Man.
The check...
Honestly, man.
Tell
them
yet.
Nah,
we gonna let them
nah.
tell
it. I probably won't ever talk about that, man. Absolutely. I appreciate it.
But we gonna let the lawyers talk about the check. All right, nah.
Yeah. But I think he came up with it, man, and he just wanted me to just put a project together that was like the final celebration of my independent career. You know what I mean? Because you talking 12 projects I did. You talking 7-8 tours.
Yep.
So my fan base was really accepting the fact that I was going to be an independent artist forever.
Right.
And in the back of my head, probably 2 years ago, I thought that was cool, you know, because I was making money and I was like, this is straight.
Yeah.
But then you get a little bit of money and you realize, like, money was never what you really wanted anyway.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I want to go out here and mean something.
Be great.
And it was just hard for me because, yeah, we was making money and, okay, we got a big house, we got nice cars, but I could still walk up to somebody that look at me like I'm still trying to figure it out.
Right.
Like, oh, so how's the rap thing going for you? Yeah. And I'm like, what? Like, if I could just tell you, but nah, you know
right,
what I mean?
Right.
I just really want to matter, man, and I'm looking on the charts, and there's people selling 150,000 albums, 200,000 albums first week,
yeah.
and I was selling 3,000-4,000, and it just didn't sit right with me, because I feel like I'm as talented, and I can bring as much to the game as them,
right.
and to the culture, so I just had to make that move, man. And I wasn't in a rush. Right. You know what I mean? Shout out to Sony. Shout out to RCA.
Who else courted you, man?
Man.
What was that process like, man? So you start doing music. You get a fan base.
Right.
Your music going crazy. You start right. touring.
Start
then
taking
start
meetings.
Calling.
Right. And they actually start calling way later than I expected.
Okay.
Way later. So, like, we had a lot going on before it. Labels was biting on me, and honestly, it's because I don't make the traditional music.
Right.
So it's like, where do we put this kid? You know what I mean? And,
right.
and before J. Cole just tore everything up,
right.
like, people didn't think it was really possible. And now, you know, J. Cole having the last 2-3 years, right. he had, man, right. it opened the gates wide yeah. open for me. So every label, like, oh, we need another J. Cole.
Yeah.
And they, like, where's that kid from 2 years ago?
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
With the fan base.
Right.
Where's he
so,
at?
So like all the labels that was talking to me, I had already had conversations with 2 years ago, and it just wasn't the right time for them.
Right.
But I had the situation where we was about to just do the whole thing big with Sony Red. Yeah. You know, I had the RCA situation.
Yeah.
A couple other ones I don't want to talk about just because I don't like them no more. Right. You know what I mean? Right. So I ain't even gonna throw no shit.
I don't even want to mention them.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Because they telling me like, oh, you think you can do this? You think you can do that without us? And you know, you won't be here in 2 years. And I'm like, okay.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you won't be here in 2 years.
Yeah.
But it took me 2 years later.
It took me 10
But 2 years later, though.
Going nowhere.
Right. Yeah. And then, so with No ID, man, I honestly was really, really, really fighting for the RCA situation.
Yeah.
Shout out to Jay Grant. Yeah. You know,
that's
he's the one that signed.
Homie, man.
Okay.
I know Jay Grant.
He the one that signed Kid Ink and everybody. Yeah. And I was really interested in that. And I was on his bumper. Like, right. I was talking to him every day. Like, look, we got to get this done. And
right.
He was like, yeah, go ahead, finish the tour off. We're going to figure it out. And while I'm on tour, I get the call from Jay Boogie. Shout out Jay Boogie. Yeah. I don't know if y'all know Jay Boogie. He from Chicago. He the one that found Dirk and all of them.
Yeah.
And, you know, he was like, yo, I got something for you. And I'm like, what you mean? He's like, I got a situation, you know. No ID interested in bringing everything back. And let's see, you know, trying to figure out what we can make happen.
Yeah.
And it's crazy because probably 2 weeks later, I probably would have signed the RCA. You know what I mean?
Right,
so
right.
It was like that timing and it being No ID. It was like, oh, okay.
I'm in.
Yeah. And I called him like a man, like, yo,
yeah.
Thank you, but I'm about to go over here with the dude that found Kanye and all them. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, no hard feelings.
Exactly.
But, you know what
exactly.
I mean? Plus, Def Jam is working a heck of a machine right now.
Right.
They got Kanye. On, they got Designer. Right. They got you know what I'm saying,
on a lot of stuff, man. Music is the centerpiece of it.
Yeah.
But like I said, I got a partnership. So, you know, he looks at me like a peer. So it's like we coming together on so many business ideas.
Absolutely.
And we trying to create so many opportunities for, you know, for my company inside his company.
Right.
You know, and of course, he got to focus on his job title, which a lot of people don't know. He's the vice president of Def Jam.
Right.
So, like, I don't think people know that. Right. I don't know why, but, like, he's the top dog over there.
Yeah.
So, it's like he got a huge responsibility. But at the end of the day, like, he know what I want to do and he know what I want to accomplish.
Right.
And he know it ain't nobody in the world that's going to stop me from doing it.
Yeah.
So, the only thing he want to do is add to it. So, I don't really got to answer to nobody. You know, I don't got to ask too many questions.
Right.
You know, like this tour, like...
It's like Jay's in the building. Back in 99,
right.
When Jay was in the Def Jam building.
Right.
You feel me?
And that's why I'm glad we came with a little stability, man.
Yeah.
You know, because this tour that I'm about to do now,
yeah.
I was going to have to do in August just because Def Jam, No ID, all of it, like all the work he had to do for the label.
Yeah.
It was... I wouldn't say it was like... putting a hold on what I was doing, but it needed to take priority because he had so much stuff he had to get done.
Right.
So I was like, okay, young one, let's just write the checks and we're gonna fund this tour ourselves. You know what I mean? And then all right, No ID, just throw me the money back in August. I got you.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So it's like the fact that we got that flexibility.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I go get my own tour bus and I'm just keep the receipts because y'all paying me back for this.
Right.
But I ain't gotta wait on y'all. I confront this 100. We gonna do what we need to do.
Yep.
And make it make sense, you know
and
what I mean?
We're gonna sell this merch.
Yep.
We're gonna get this money up.
Yep.
All right.
Sell these tickets.
Come on, man.
So,
come on, man.
So we just jumping out here, man. And I'm excited for this year.
I'm so excited.
Huge, huge singles coming
huge
out.
Records.
Some big features.
Features.
With
can
some
you, can you give one? One? I might get on Vlad.
Man. I don't know. You got to think, I just got with the label.
I know. Don't, that's all right. That's all
right. I might mess something up.
Don't even do that. Don't even take it there.
Right, right.
But just know.
Just tell them.
He got big features coming.
Big.
They
big.
You know what I'm saying? We'll wait on them.
Stay tuned in.
Right.
Just make sure
we, you know what I'm saying, get a clean and a dirty. You
I got you.
Boom.
I got you.
Absolutely.
Already. You know
what I'm
saying?
Yeah, we going in.
Right. So, you know, kind of in closing, you know what I'm saying, I know you got to do your thing and get out of here. But, you know, I want you to talk about, you know, again, let's go back to the city because I want the artists. There's a lot of artists out there that's been, you know, like you said, speculating and talking and the city speculating and talking and everybody seems to have the answers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Except for the people that have the answers. You know what I'm saying?
Straight up.
But straight I want up. You to really, you know, talk to the city right now, man, and really talk about, number one, the drive and the sacrifice that it's taking you to get to this point. And number two, you know, Sway got a couple answers, man.
I mean, honestly, I'm at a weird place right now. I'm at a place I never been career-wise. Mentally, I'm at a place I never been. I'm really confident in all the decisions I've been making.
Right.
And I mean, but sometimes it's hard for me to sleep, man, because I know how crazy it is. I know how tough it is growing up where we from.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's a hard way to approach it. Like, it's really difficult to try to figure out how you fix it, because no matter what moves you make, it's still a group of people that's going to feel like they left out.
Right.
'Cause our city ain't just suffering on the inner city. You know what I mean? It's a lot of kids in the outskirts that in these Carmel areas and Brownsburg. It's a huge drug epidemic out there. You know what I mean?
Struggle,
a lot of these
is
kids
universal.
These kids is overdosing and everything. So it's like, I feel like it's so much that I could attack, but it's like, I need everybody to understand that it's gonna take a unified effort. You know what I mean? Like, it can't just be Mark Battles out here and, oh, we don't like him, so we ain't gonna mess with him, or, oh, we like him, so we gonna mess with him. Everybody gotta feel like they can do everything I'm doing. You know what I mean? And that goes to the individual. Like, the mindset, the hustle I got all came from me being from that, period. Right. Ain't no other influence. I never seen nothing else besides Indianapolis. And if I could think like this, right, I don't see why everybody can't think like this.
Right.
I went to the same schools. You was in Arlington. I went to the same schools. I went to the same neighborhood parties. I went to all of that. And I understood that it was going to take a bigger mindset to get out.
Right.
And I just want to spread that energy, man.
Right.
So, like, we can put it on record now. Like, I'm picking somebody up from the city. You know what I mean? I might get two or three. It's not like I'm in a little situation.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I got a label deal. I could have 10 artists. I can get a budget for 10 artists.
Right.
It's just those 10 people got to make sense with what I'm trying to do.
Absolutely.
It can't battle against everything I'm trying to accomplish. You know
right.
what I mean? So if
right.
all your music is just all negative, how can I bring you, you know what I mean, on my
right.
team when I'm trying to stop the negativity in my city?
Right.
So I don't want people to think I'm against that. It's
right.
just I'm on a mission.
Right.
I don't want to keep going to funerals. So if all you talking about is killing people, you can't rock with me, period.
Right.
Like, it's not no, you know what I mean? I like some of the music. I like the production. I like the style. We got a unique style here, but it's so many people fighting against what I'm trying to accomplish.
Right.
So it's like, it's hard for me to figure it out. So I'm going to take a different approach too. It's not just artists, like the models, the entrepreneurs, the DJs, the radio personalities, and the people that, the songwriters, just anybody that's trying to do something.
Right.
Anybody that's creative and anybody that actually got what it take. Because that's the centerpiece.
Absolutely.
You can have the hustle and all of that, but
yeah.
if you ain't got the it factor or the talent, I just can't do nothing with you. You know,
right.
I got to believe in it.
Right.
But I'm grabbing people, man. Like,
that's
we about to make it happen. Like, I'm trying to turn this into something where people come through here because, like, they know it's money here.
Right.
We can go get money through Nap, shoot over to Chicago. You know what I mean? It ain't
right.
like that yet.
Right.
We forcing people to come here, and we overpaying people to come here.
Absolutely.
Like, I know niggas like, hey, yeah, I got a bag out there. They was ready to pay anything. And I'm like, man, y'all doing my city like that?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They go down the street to Chicago half off. No reason, just because it's Chicago. So why
and
can't we do it like
people,
that?
Way more people, way bigger market. You know
right.
what I'm saying?
So it's like, I just want to create a culture, man. So we could put it out there.
Yeah.
I got my eyes open.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I ain't home all the time, but
right.
I got people that live here. I got eyes out here. And I just want I want people that's really ready to make something happen, man.
Yeah.
'Cause this ain't easy. This ain't gonna be all fun and just partying. Like, I'm trying to accomplish something big. You know what I mean? My ultimate goal, I want to be the biggest artist ever. So if you don't believe you can be the biggest model ever or the biggest radio personality ever, I can't mess with you.
Absolutely.
Like, we ain't going to connect on nothing,
because right.
I dream too big.
Yep.
I'm not just cool with $1 million. You know
right.
what I mean? Not bragging.
We need 10.
Yeah.
And then we need 25.
Right.
Then you we feel need me? 100.
Right.
Then we'll flip that to the next one. You know what I'm saying? Y'all right. Sold for that next one. We get to that 100, we're going to flip that to the next page.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? We're going to start building African, we gonna, you know what I mean, the water wells in Africa. You know, we're going to get our Akon.
Make it something happen.
Million. So y'all stay tuned for that.
Man. It's about the kids. It's about the city, man. It's about us believing in ourselves. It's about us understanding that hating on each other ain't going to do nothing.
Right. Nothing.
You know what I mean? And honestly, like, I want more for me and for the people around me and for the people that grew up how I grew up. I just want more for all of us. So whatever it's going to take for us to make that happen, let's make it happen. Like, I'm about to start doing concerts out here. I'm about to start bringing all the celebrities out here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm going to open up a spot. I ain't trying to step on nobody's toes, but I'm just saying it now.
Yeah.
I'm going to open up a spot. You know what I mean? And it's not going to be a club. It's going to be a concert venue.
Yeah.
So it's like just a little different. You know what I mean? To bring people through. Right. Exactly. Right.
I totally understand where you're going with that. And
right.
Indianapolis needs that because if you can't go to Deer Creek, then you can't, you know what I'm saying, you or White River, you know, you pretty much can't,
you can't
perform in a venue like
right.
that. And the city loves that type of artist.
Man,
as well,
they do.
You know? So,
they do.
I saw you one post, you know, one other thing I want to talk about. I saw one post. That
I ain't in no rush, bro.
All right, cool, cool. So we in here. I saw a post that you had placed up that said, you know, a lot of people say my city don't support me, but
right.
I looked at my iTunes numbers.
Right.
Yeah.
And 75, or I don't remember the number.
Yeah, it wasn't that high. It was like
35,000.
Yeah, 30. It was like 35%.
Well, we need to get them numbers up, but 35% of your sales can come from Indianapolis. You know
yeah,
what
they
I'm
did.
Saying? You know, talk a little bit about how that felt, you know, and where else are your sales coming from?
Right.
Well?
I mean, that was a huge shock to me.
Yeah.
Huge, because I go to cities and I do 1,000 people, 1,500 people, you know what I mean, at my concert. So, like, that's where I expected the energy to be at. And it was there, but I don't know, man. Like, I really can't explain it still. You know,
yeah.
I really can't. But when I seen those numbers, it was like, it was 30-some percent. And it opened my eyes, like, it can happen.
Yeah.
It really can happen.
Right.
And people ready to support somebody that's really going to go out here and do what they're supposed to do.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? But we just got to get people used to understanding what real support is. You know what I mean? Like, if you got all my music and you just downloaded it and you ain't never been to a concert and you watch all my videos on YouTube and that's it, you know, like, that ain't real support. Support is really going out here and spreading the music and spreading the love. Oh, you heard about this guy, that guy.
Yeah.
You know, I think this dude can do that.
What'd that say right there? What'd that say?
Purchased. I love it.
My dog. You
right.
You know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
We was in that percentage, dog. We want something that's real.
Right.
Like you said, man, if it's real, bro, we going to purchase. You
right.
know what I'm saying? We going to buy that thing.
We
man.
Got
he
to.
He got merch, too. He got merch, too.
Oh, yeah. We got it all.
We purchased.
But, come on, but yeah, so I think we ready, man.
Yeah.
I think we ready. It's a lot of talented artists. It's a lot of talented. It's just a lot of creative
is
people.
Is anybody specific on your radar?
Yeah, it's an artist from out east. I call him Cannon. His name is Chris Cannon. I don't even know if y'all know him. He's
yeah.
crazy, man. He's
oh,
super
yeah.
dope. It's an artist that's been around for a minute that I'm a big fan of. His name is Tragic. I don't know him personally, but man,
that's the homie. No. He's well connected.
He cold.
Hey, that record in due time right now.
Yeah,
that video.
Dope.
Oh, he's cute. I'm glad you said Tragic.
I like.
Shout out to my dog.
Absolutely, I like Rob Ski. I like
trap.
Yeah, I like Skip. I man, it's crazy. Like, I used to bring Skip to the studio, Monkey Boy Studio, with me back in like 2010, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he's like my age, but like, I really ain't talked to him since them days. But
yeah.
I kind of follow what he was doing. You know, I like him a lot.
He got an album getting ready to drop.
Okay,
Jaffe.
Yeah, yeah.
And
so,
shout out to
all my fans that ain't from Indianapolis, y'all hearing this, support my home team, man. It's a lot of people out here doing great things. You know what I mean? But it's more than just artists. Like, it's a lot of creative people. You know what I mean?
Right.
And one person I'm a huge fan of, and I ain't just saying that because I'm here, and that's you.
Right,
you know what I mean? Your hustle, your mentality. I feel like if everybody just sat and listened, all it is, and I just connected with your mentality. But,
you know, to say taboo to that, you know what I'm saying? I've always been, like I said, a huge fan of the whole movement. You know, I've been a huge fan of the team. You know what I'm saying? Be Easy.
Oh,
you know
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
You know, a lot of people don't know this. You know what I'm saying? That Be Easy, you know, I sent him a blast and I said, yo, you got to listen to this kid.
Right.
It was, I think it was the joint you dropped with Wayne.
Okay. In 2012?
Yeah, that young one laughed. Yeah.
Yeah, let's not spend no time on that.
Far away, Jordan, yeah. Whatever. Anyhow. Yeah. I think, but I sent him a, No. It was the joint you dropped with Kid Ink.
Kid Ink, okay.
What was the name of that record?
Last Night.
Last Night.
Terrible record. Terrible.
I sent Be Easy. I sent Be Easy last night. Right?
Right.
I sent him last night.
Right.
And he hit me directly back and said, yo, who is this kid?
Right.
This is crazy.
That's crazy.
This is crazy.
That's crazy.
And he was down in Atlanta. You know what I'm
saying?
And, you know, the rest is history, of course. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my dog. You know, he does plugs. Stopbeefinradio every Friday.
Oh, yeah.
Friday. Easy Fridays.
Easy.
Absolutely.
Easy does it. But, you know, I just, you know, I just see, like you said, like minds, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like hustles intermingling and making it make sense, man. So
right.
We appreciate you, you know, recognizing iHustle, because it's not just me. It's a team of all of us to make.
That's beautiful.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. To make it happen. Skrill, you
right.
know what I mean? And Juan and
right.
everybody around Treez. All of
right.
us around, you know what I mean? We make Stop Beef and Radio. You
right.
know what I'm saying? It's not.
And that's what it
I'm
takes.
I face a lot. You know
right.
what I'm saying? But we have an entire team, you know
right.
what I'm saying, that does the same thing, and you know, so.
And y'all got my support, man. Anything we got to do, and anything we got to do to just make it bigger, because
yeah.
now it's not just about us accomplishing things and being happy to say, oh, we did this. Like, it's really about us making some noise and creating some jobs for people out
Absolutely.
Here. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Like I said, I got 10 people that, you know, work with my company, and you got all these people that work with you. Uh-huh. Imagine if everybody could create that. It'd be so many more opportunities and less, you know, less hate in it and
yeah.
more of a unified effort.
It'd be too busy.
Right. You know what I mean? Because we got to work, you know? And
on,
I can't leave out Coach K, man. For some reason,
Coach K.
A lot of people don't know that that's my manager. You know, I got two managers, Phil Hogan and Coach K. And,
okay.
and he's done
Shout
so much.
Phil.
Yeah, absolutely.
Coach K.
Coach K.
Yeah.
Okay, so
both
yeah.
from Indianapolis.
So
yeah.
Talk about that.
Coach, yeah. You know, Coach, he worked with a lot of artists that are so different from me.
Yeah.
So I'm never tied in that world. So you don't never see me with the Migos and all them dudes. But
yeah.
yeah, like
he moved the same way.
Man, he's done so much for me. And he was integral in getting this deal situated for me.
Right.
You know what I mean? And he's the one that's bringing me home for my homecoming show. So we
homecoming show officially announced.
Absolutely. Finally.
Now,
Man. So we coming home in September, man. We coming home in September.
September, man.
My first time ever. Yeah, and I did Fort Wayne like a year ago, and it was
yeah.
nuts. It was crazy.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, when I go to Indianapolis, we're going to do like 3,000-4,000.
Yeah.
So
that's what's up.
Yeah, so.
So I want you to elaborate, too, you know what I mean, Coach K and
mm-hmm.
his philosophy. Of course, like you said, he's got different artists.
Right.
But he also has a stable of different artists.
Like right, he does.
The Migos are not the same as, you know, the other OG Mako.
Right.
Who's not the Yachty same
and all
that. Greatness.
Right.
Who's not, you know what I'm saying? Talk about that. And how that, you know, intermingles and rolls.
I mean, Coach is just a brilliant person, man.
Yeah, man.
You know what I mean? If you know Coach, anybody know Coach, like, he's just an incredible guy.
Yeah.
And the way he look at life is so different.
Yeah.
If you got a mediocre way of living, you can't even survive in Coach world.
Right.
Like, Coach is so big-minded,
yeah.
you got to be ready, put your hard hat on and go, or he
right.
going to leave you behind.
Right.
So, you know, the only people I know that ever even say anything negative about him is lazy people. You know what I mean?
Right.
Honestly. Because he's ready to go. He going all the time. But,
yeah.
I mean, we just getting started.
Oh,
you
yeah.
know what I mean? Like,
oh,
this
yeah.
is just the beginning.
It's the beginning. The
Absolutely.
Starting line. They let us in the starting line. I tweeted
yeah.
you that. When you tweeted the deal, I said, oh, they finally let us to the starting line.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's about
so,
to be huge.
And so with that, you know, I know you got some artists on the label.
Right.
Vasi Family.
Right.
You know, that whole deal and situation and,
right.
and all your guys. Talk a little bit about some of the artists that you're working with right now.
Right. Well, I got Rick Vasi. You know what I mean? Ricky, yeah. He just came back, but he was on Fly America with me when we first started back in 2010, 2011.
Right.
So we basically grew up together, you know, and he had moved down to go to school, and that didn't work out the way he wanted it to, and I said, come on back with open arms. So he back now, you know what I mean? He been rocking for like a couple months.
That's what's
and
up.
Then, you know, I picked up my new artist, Jace Houston, but...
Yep. Where's he from?
He's from... California, San Bernardino, yeah.
San Bernardino.
And yeah, so.
Hey, man, so you going to have me in Orange County. With the, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
With the Hot Wives or with the Housewives of
Orange County. Straight
Bernardino.
Up. Yeah, yeah. Right, so, man. But I'm just interested in collaborating with people that just want to go out here and create something dope. You know what I mean? Designers. Yeah. Anybody that just got a creative mind, that's all I'm about. Like, even when I was in my toughest times, like, I was the kid in the back of the class writing poetry and stuff. You know what I mean? That's just me.
Right.
And then, you know what I mean? I go outside and we get in our fights and all of that. But then I'm back in the house. I'm 10 years old thinking about being Jay-Z. Like, right. And that was real to me. You know what I mean? I'm walking right. around with the chains and I'm trying to rap like him, trying to be Biggie. And that just stuck with me my whole life. And this go down to parenting. This go down to mentoring. Like, respect the people that really want to see you succeed. Because once you start getting some traction, those people are so critical. It's like, without my mom and without DJ Young One and all these people...
Right.
When I finally started getting some momentum, it would have just fizzled away without them.
Right.
Because then you need that support. You know what I mean? You need those people.
Anchors.
That, yeah, you need that, man. And shout out to my moms. Like, I was 5, 6 years old, and she's showing me pictures of Martin Luther King and Abraham Lincoln and John F. Kennedy and Malcolm X. She's showing me pictures of these people saying, you're going to be like them one day.
Right.
Every night, tucking me in, I'm going to bed, and she telling me, you're going to be great like these people.
Wow.
That's what I got my whole life.
Right.
So that's why it's easy for me to dream like this, because, you know what I mean, she was making me think I was going to be the greatest man in the world. Yeah, so
that's real.
That's huge, man. Shouts if you got kids out here, like, make sure y'all doing it the right way.
Yeah.
Straight up.
You have kids?
Absolutely. I got 3.
I see you on the snap with you, you know what I mean, with your kids.
All the time. Yeah, he here. My son here right now. He go everywhere with me. He been on the road all year.
Already?
Yeah.
Take the youngins out so he can see the greatness as well.
Man, he think he's so famous, too.
That's what's up, man. So, the tour, y'all leaving on Sunday.
Absolutely.
Leaving on Sunday.
We out.
How can the people get tickets to the tour?
Right.
Where are y'all going?
Right.
What's going on, man?
We going everywhere. We going everywhere, man. You can check out flyamericatour.com.
Yep.
Make sure you you pick up some tickets from there. The album is out. The album just dropped a week ago. Get on iTunes, Google Music, Spotify, any of that. Pick up Before the Deal.
Yeah.
Man, it's about to get huge. Like, anybody that's excited about this right now is almost laughable to me, because we got so much more about to come.
Right.
Like, this is not where it stops. This ain't, that dude almost had it.
Yeah.
Like, we about to get it.
Right.
And whoever with it, like, let's go. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Like, I'm with whoever just trying to make it happen.
Yep.
So,
You know we trying to make it happen, Captain.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
We're going to come out there on the tour. Yeah. We're going to come out
let's
a couple
it.
Days, man.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
Told you, Housewives of California.
What's the first stop, man? What's
we
the
in
first
Arizona,
stop?
And then the second stop is L.A.
Okay.
Yep. That's June 19th. We're going to L.A.
Arizona.
Yeah. But we everywhere. We shooting out here. You know, we hit New York, Chicago.
Yeah.
And it's crazy because when I go to Chicago, you'll think I was from there. You know, I pack out Chicago. Crazy.
Oh, yeah.
800 people, 900 people. They show so much love.
Yeah.
So I'm right down the street. You know what I mean? They look at it like it's the home team.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
That's what it is, man.
It's so crazy, man. So, like... At the end of this, you know, when you leave here, you know what I'm saying, and y'all go on tour and, you know, you come back and you settle down, what are you going to say to yourself, you know what I'm saying, just, you know, the reflection, what are you going to say to yourself as you move on to the next thing, you know what I'm saying? Give people some insight on what you don't tell them on records.
Honestly... The main thing that I focus on that I kind of keep out the spotlight is just living in the moment. You know what I mean? Because we all know the person that had the glory days and then they just harp on those moments for the rest of their life.
Yeah.
And they never get that feeling back.
Yeah.
So I just want to create this feeling that I got for the people around me. And I want other people to get to experience the way it feel to live your dream. It ain't nothing like it, man. You know what I mean? It ain't nothing like it. It's an amazing experience. Even like today was a stressful day for me because I had so much going on. And then I'm running late for y'all. And I'm like, oh, I can't let them down. I'm in, you know what I mean? I'm trying to get dressed real quick.
Right.
And the whole time, I'm still in the back of my head like, I'm about to go on tour. My album killing on Billboard right now. You know what I mean? I could just text, no ID. Like, how crazy is that? You know what I mean? Like, you can't name five producers in hip hop and not name him. You know what I mean? So it's like I could just hit him like, hey, bro, you about to watch the game?
Yeah.
Like, that's real life for me. So it's like, you know, it's just important to live in a moment and appreciate these things, but just never settle. Yeah. I want it all. Yeah. I want everybody around me to have it all.
Yeah.
I'm a humble dude, but I like nice things, and I want to keep having nice things, and I want everybody to know what it feels like to have nice things. So, like, whatever we got to do, I'm here. I ain't going to make it seem like I'm super approachable. It's really hard to find me, but if you connect it.
It is hard to find.
If you will connect it.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because. You know, without Jelly, you know what I'm saying?
He, yeah.
Bring it to the hood. Goddamn.
Right.
Nah, man. You know, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah, come but on. Just get connected with my people, man. Yeah. I like it that way, though. I like for people to have to connect with my team because we got to build. So it's like, yeah, you got to talk to Jelly. You got to talk to Phil. You got to talk to Young One. Yeah. Let's make it important for people to feel like they got to build relationships to make something happen. Because that's the real world.
Absolutely.
I built a relationship with No ID for 2 years before I got this deal.
Right.
So it's like people think you could just get hot and everything going to go your way. You got to have people skills out here. You got to be able to talk. You know what I mean? You got to be able to sell yourself.
Right.
So like it's important for you to have to go to my team and make it seem like it's something that makes sense for us to be interested in. Right. And I just like to keep it that way. Plus, you know, I own a club, so it's like it's hard to find me. I ain't never in the club or nothing. I'm just in the studio or something. But if you get connected with the people, and I'm gonna make y'all some gatekeepers too, and we gonna make everybody understand that we gonna have to come together before anything happen.
Yeah,
definitely.
Period.
Because I want to point out too, it's not easy moving around an army. You know what I'm saying? My man moves with an army, like you know. Like, when he say team, literally there's a team. And it ain't no whole bunch of cats just standing around just because they want to hang out with battles because he home. Everybody has a job.
Everybody working.
Everybody working. Everybody got a job.
Working hard.
Come on, man.
Yeah. That's real, man. Well, look, man, we're going to let you get out of here, man. We appreciate you, man. You know what I'm saying? Rocking with us, man. You know what I'm saying? Stop Beefing Radio, man. Again, man, tell them again before you get out of here how they can get in contact with you on social media, how they can get tickets on the tour and all that.
Well, just hit us up, man. You know, you can find me on Twitter, MarkBattles317, Instagram, MarkBattles317, Snapchat, MarkBattles317. You want to get in contact with us, you know, you hit up Phil Hogan, you hit up DJ Young One, or you hit up the email, Fly America Beats, you know, and let's just build something, man.